Almighty God, grant us a quiet night and peace at the last.
Amen.
By day, O God, you grant your steadfast love, and at night your song is with me.
A prayer to the God of my life.
Holy and gracious God, I confess that I have sinned against you this day. Some of my sins I know, the thoughts and words and deeds of which I am ashamed, but some is known only to you. In the name of Jesus Christ, I ask forgiveness. Deliver and restore me, that I may rest in peace. By the mercy of God, we are united with Jesus Christ, in whom we are forgiven. We rest now in the peace of Christ and rise in the morning to serve.
Psalm 130. Out of the depths I cry to you, O Lord. O Lord, hear my voice. Let your ears be attentive to the voice of my supplication. If you were to keep watch over sins, O Lord, who could stand? Yet with you is forgiveness, in order that you may be feared. I wait for you, O Lord. My soul waits. In your word is my hope. My soul waits for the Lord more than those who keep watch for the morning. More than those who keep watch for the morning. O Israel, wait for the Lord, for with the Lord there is steadfast love. With the Lord there is plenteous redemption. For the Lord shall redeem Israel from all their sins. God of compassion, you sent your word into the world to announce the dawn of salvation. Do not leave us in the depths of our sins, but give to us the fullness of your redeeming grace. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. A reading from Genesis. God said to Noah and to his sons with him, "As for me, I am establishing my covenant with you and your descendants after you, and with every living creature that is with you, the birds, the domestic animals, and every animal of the earth with you, as many as came out of the ark. I establish my covenant with you, that never again shall all flesh be cut off by the waters of a flood, and never again shall there be a flood to destroy the earth." God said, "This is the sign of the covenant that I make between me and you and every living creature that is with you for all generations. I have set my bow in the clouds, and it shall be a sign of the covenant between me and the earth. When I bring clouds over the earth and the bow is seen in the clouds, I will remember my covenant that is between me and you and every living creature of all flesh. And the waters shall never again become a flood to destroy all flesh. When the bow is in the clouds, I will see it and remember the everlasting covenant between God and every living creature of all flesh that is on the earth. God said to Noah, "This is the sign of the covenant that I have established between me and all flesh that is on the earth." Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
On and off in my life, I've kept a simple prayer journal, taking the time each day to transfer forward names and thanking God for intervening in the lives of the people around me, whether I knew them or not. This week, the needs of our community, it's a lengthy list. People we know and love are in pain, in the hospital, sitting vigil, missing a beloved, concerned for the great many needs of our community, country, and world. Life is a mess. Good people, righteous, kind, dear people suffer before our eyes, and we are often powerless to stop it. Thoughts and prayers are often ridiculed, and rightly so, when they are the impotent inaction of powerful people shirking their duty. But we cannot forget that seeking God's blessing is a powerful act. When we pray, we risk being the answer to our prayer, being the witnesses of God's mighty intervention, that God might bless this mess we can't explain. It is interesting that we think that the story of Noah is appropriate for children. We can't resist the darling image of a floating zoo, the 2x2 animals just begging to be rendered by artists and woodworkers. But this isn't a neat and tidy little story. It is a story where life is brought to an end. I can imagine the terror of Noah and Mrs. Noah, their children and their children's spouses, as the waters rose and rose until what was once fertile fields and grazing lands became an endless ocean, as debris of what was floated by and bodies. These were not just random people, but they were their neighbors. I once heard it reasoned that the "Oh God" we so often utter in the face of unspeakable tragedy is in and of itself a prayer, and a very true one. This is a tough story to redeem, and honestly, I will not try to do so. There are just some stories that cannot be explained away, no simple platitude that can make up for the loss of life. I cannot explain the more than 50 people who were killed in last week's storm. I cannot explain away the 6 deaths at the U.S. Capitol last month. I will not explain away the lives of victims of mass shootings. I will not explain away the deaths of Black people, Indigenous people, immigrants. I will not explain away the deaths of those who hopelessly took their own lives. I will not explain away the losses that you have experienced and that you are experiencing in your lives today. I will not explain away the messiness of human life. I only know this. When our prayers to God about this mess that we cannot explain, are answered, and when we lean into what God, the heart of our being, is telling us, then the blessing will come. The blessing will come when we comfort one another. The blessing will come when we help each other rebuild. The blessing will come when we enact laws that protect our neighbors.
The blessing will come when we refuse to speak that which should not be said. And the blessing will come when we refuse to be silent when we must speak out. The blessing will come when we mirror God's loving actions and lay down our.
Oh, I'm gonna homily later. Okay.
Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
Into your hands I commend my spirit.
You have redeemed me, O Lord God of truth.
Into your hands I commend my spirit.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Into your hands I commend my spirit.
Guide us waking, O Lord, and guard us sleeping, that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep we may rest in peace.
Now, Lord, let your servant go in peace. Your word has been fulfilled. My own eyes have seen the salvation which you have prepared in the sight of every people, a light to reveal you to the nations, and the glory of your people Israel. Guide us waking, O Lord, and guard us sleeping, that awake we may watch with Christ, and asleep we may rest in peace.
Hear my prayer, O Lord.
Listen to my cry.
Keep me as the apple of your eye.
Hide me in the shadow of your wings.
In righteousness I shall see you.
When I awake, your presence will give me joy.
Be present, merciful God, and protect us through the hours of this night, so that we who are wearied by the changes and chances of life may find our rest in you. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done.
bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Almighty and merciful God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep us this night and forevermore.
Amen.
Go in peace. Christ is with you.
Thanks be to God.